थैंक यू। एक ओंकार सतनाम करता पुरख निर्भौ निर्वैर अकाल मूरत अजूनी सहभंग गुर प्रसाद जप आद सच जुगाद सच है भी सच नानक होसी भी सच। In summary, what does that explain to us? That there is this one universal creator, almighty God Vaheguruji. The name is truth, creative being personified, you can say. No fear, no hatred, totally fearless, totally without enmity, no enemies, no hatred. It's the image of the undying and it's beyond birth, self-existent, and it is only by the grace of my Guruji, it's with the grace of our Guruji that we can get to do what's called japa, chant and meditate on the name of this almighty Vaheguruji, God himself. Because he was true in the primal beginning, true throughout the ages, true here and now, and Tan Tan Sri Guru Nanak Dev Ji says, forever and ever Vaheguruji shall be true. And maybe that's what you and I should aspire. You and I should aspire to have the values that I just shared with you in our life, and we should become exactly, and that's how we re-merge with the light of the Supreme Almighty Vaheguruji. But in the next part, Guruji explains Soche, Soch na hovai, je sochi lakwar. This physical body, and look at the body itself. If we clean it again and again, many a times, thinking that it is going to be purified from the anant karan, from our a lot of you can say the illnesses, number one, the bad karmas we carry, the past actions we have done, and their responses that we have to pay for this time, or maybe a lot of inverted comma bad things that we have upon us. We think that the physical body, by just cleaning that physical body, we can purify all that from the unreasonable worldly love called rag, and enemy like the vek, the vek. And although the physical body can be, you know, washed 100,000 lakh, lakh means 100,000 times, je sochi lakh var, lakh. Lakh, lakh, you have to pronounce it very much to think about the idea that even if you physically clean the body again and again, and that's some people's definition of the word sochi, soche and sochi in this particular part of Gurbani. But the other way of thinking is soche also means the idea of thinking, and thinking even more deeply and contemplating. And Guruji says by thinking alone, you cannot reduce Vaheguruji Almighty to your thoughts, even by thinking 100,000 times. Now, I'm not going to spend time which is the right definition, because soche could have double, multiple meanings. One being the physical cleansing of the body, then the other soch meaning just repetitive thinking and focusing and thinking and rethinking again and again. But either way, it brings us back to the point that just the physical cleaning of the body is not going to, you know, purify our minds, and neither just by thinking alone and thinking alone are you going to be able to understand the greatness of Vaheguruji. Maybe it's our aspiration to become as great as Vaheguruji. And in the next line, Guruji says, chupe chup na hovai je lai raha livtar. Although you may refrain yourself from speaking again and again, some people like to keep quiet and they say I'm in deep silent meditation, but Guruji says the mind never becomes mute from creating your thoughts. They are called your sankalps, and Guruji says there are also counter thoughts, the viklaps, the thoughts that are going to be running in our minds, whether it's the subconscious mind or the conscious mind, the semi-conscious or the super-conscious, these thoughts are never going to stop. Even if by remaining silent, we think we can control and obtain inner silence, Guruji says no. Even by lovingly remain absorbed deep within yourself, by remaining silent, inner silence cannot be obtained. Because these were the practices in the past that people used to promote and say, you know, if you do this kind of silent meditations, or if you do these kind of remaining quiet, or, you know, physical cleansing, or just focus on that one thought again and again, you will have God, you will understand God. But maybe Guruji is explaining to us, no, these may be challenging methods. So what are the solutions? We'll discover that in a minute. But the next line says, pokhyan pokhna utri je banna puriyan bhar. Remaining hungry physically, You know, some people do want to remain. Now, here I'm not talking about dieting for the sake of healthy living because you're overweight and the doctors told you to go and diet. Good, that's for health reasons you are dieting. But if you just remain physically hungry and think that that will help you achieve oneness with God and salvation, Guruji says it will not vanish the greed, the hunger of worldly materials. Even if you and I were to obtain a pile containing the materials available everywhere in the universe, and if all these materials were given to us, we had them right in front of us, yet we will still yearn for more. And in the same way, the hunger for, the greed for, the aspirations to have even more and more will never die. Even if we abstain from food, the greed for worldliness will never vanish. And the greed will never vanish even if we have everything, all material goods in our life, in our bank accounts, in our assets classifications. Because the hungry of the hunger, or rather the hunger of the hungry, either way. So whether the hungry are going to be even more hungry all the time, and the hunger is never going to be appeased. The hunger of the hungry is not going to be appeased even by piling up loads of worldly goods. So there were two kinds of extremes. Some people thought that if I abstain from food and I become hungry, I will slowly but surely lose all desires for worldliness. On the other hand, people thought if I get everything out there in the world, once it's all mine, then I will not be hungry. But Guruji says, no la, either way, it's not going to help. So next comes in, even if a person has obtained hundreds of thousands of worldly intelligence, okay, maybe I don't have intelligence, I can't even pronounce the word intelligence, but forgive me. The Guruji says, even if you can accumulate all the intelligence of the world, get lots of degrees, diploma, masters and PhDs, and read all the books and get all the knowledge, listen to all the MP3s in today's context for the matter, but not even one of these intelligences, you can say, goes along to obtain the almighty Vaheguruji. That's why it says hundreds of thousands of clever tricks. That's Siyanapa, actually. If you look at the word Siyanapa, it's not just knowledge or intelligence. Siyanapa also refers to the idea of clever tricks. We all think, you know, the mind, it's very, very creative. And even if we have hundreds of thousands of clever tricks, but not even one will go along with us in the end. And that's something we got to always think about. So next comes the very first question in the Sri Guru Granth Sahib Ji. And we don't have to search very far because the answer will be given to us in the next line itself. And with that, I will conclude today's topic, because we may have to spend maybe the rest of the day today to understand this one question. And then, of course, look at the answer that Guruji is suggesting, and then allow that to go within into our subconscious and maybe live our lives upon the answer that Guruji is going to give us. Now, this is still Ang number 1, line number 6 of the Sri Guru Granth Sahib Ji and my Guruji. .com. You can download the world's very first computerized Sri Guru Granth Sahib Ji. Read along on your computers at home if you have that. Or today our phones have all kinds of apps and you can download. This is the best way to understand Gurbani. As you turn with me to Ang number 1, line number 6, the very first question that comes in. It says, give. Now, if you notice, I stop after certain words and there are pauses that I take. The reason is, Gurbani, if you understand and you read it with understanding and you give the right pauses at the right moments, sometimes you don't even need others to explain. So right now, of course, I'm helping you understand what Guruji is saying. But a day will come if you pause at the right point in the right part of Gurbani. And if you listen to these sharings again and again, slowly but surely, you will learn automatically where to have that pauses. And if you pause after the word give, then you pause after the word sachyara hoye, that phrase. And then you again pause after the word give. And then you end the line with gure to tepal. Then you will just understand, I've just broken up this entire short question into four parts. Give, sachyara hoye. Give, gure to tepal. And the question Guruji is asking then, how can we all become truthful enough to obtain Almighty Vaheguruji, and how will the curtain of falsehood be torn? Because earlier we just discussed so many different alternative methods that were being taught during the times of Gurujis, and maybe even today, and many practices that people used to do hoping to become truthful, to have the illusion, the veil of illusion be torn away. So Guruji says very simply, so how can we become truthful? How can the veil of illusion be torn away? Maybe two questions, not one. Although they mean the same thing. Kiv sachyara huye, kiv kure tutepal. So two different questions. And Guruji says the answer in the next line. Hukam razai chalana nanak. Likhya nal. Notice I spoke it in three different parts. Hukam razai chalana, that's one part. Nanak, and you take a break there. Likhya nal. The answer is very simple. Tantan Sri Guru Nanak Dev Ji says, one must stay consistently delighted. You should just live in a life of that delightful life, happiness, joy, all the time being in Chardi Kala, even during blissful moments of your life and also during painful moments of your life. Now, this is a very important message. I think during these challenging times, we need to share with everybody. So forward this to all your friends and share with them. Because hukam razai chalana. Guruji says, whether it's good times, whether it's bad times, whether it's happiness, whether it's sorrowful, whether it's joy and prosperity, or whether it's poverty and sadness, blissful or painful moments of our life, we must always learn to live in the will of Vaheguruji, realizing that the reality truly is only one thing, that whatever happens is in accordance to Almighty Vaheguruji's will, and it is based on the previous deeds, the karma, some people say, previous actions, because whatever we have sown, so shall we reap. Now all this likhya nal means it has been written upon our foreheads, some people say, but it doesn't matter where it was written. The point is very simple. The question was, how do we become truthful? How do we live a life of integrity? And how can this veil of illusion be torn away? And Tantan Sri Guru Nanak Dev Ji said, it is written. Likhya nal, look at these two words. It is written that you shall obey the hukam of his command, Vaheguruji's command, and walk in the way of his will. Because this was written and preordained already based on the previous actions, the deeds we have done. So this tells us one thing. Whatever happens in our life, whether it's good, whether it's bad, whether it's a blissful moment, whether it's a painful moment, whether it's a life of prosperity, whether it's a life of poverty, whether it's a life of happiness, joy and all good things, or whether it's a life that you're going through right now through sadness, the moment we start to live in the will of God, and later on we will discuss lots of great Shabads and historical references, like in the times of the fifth Guru, Sri Guru Arjan Dev Ji, sitting on the hot tawa, the hot plate, he was basically being tortured in every possible way. He had hot sand poured over his head, later on to be boiled in hot boiling water. And throughout the whole, you can say, incident of being tortured, because he did not want to give up his faith, his religion, and he wanted to walk steadfastly on the path of Sikhi. And he was tortured, and he was given all kinds of, bribes to also have a better life if he adopted the other religions of those times and gave up his path. But he says, no, it is hukam razai chalana. And he didn't ask that these painful moments be stopped. But all he says, tera kiya mitha lage har naam padarat nanak mange. He says, all I ask for is the name of you, O Lord Vaheguru, that all times I just chant. Remember, we discussed japa, chant and meditate. That is the whole entire one singular command on the very first page of the very first ang of Sri Guru Granth Sahib Ji, and maybe that's the command for our lives. If you like this, please share it with everyone, subscribe, click on the bell button, like this, put your positive comments, and we will every day share something beautiful so that our lives can also become beautiful. And let's share it with everyone, because Sarbat Dapala, the good of all mankind, is what we aspire and we pray for. I thank you once again for listening to these beautiful messages again. This is your Palji. Have a good day, have a good time ahead. Thank you.